Good morning, students. And so the last topic we have completed the hepatitis virus, and now the next new topic I am going to deal, that is the rotavirus. Okay, so this rotavirus is a major disease that is causing mainly the viral infection. Okay, so that is going to be cause the diarrheal illness. Okay, mostly in the human infants in the worldwide, and these transmission of the rotavirus is more. Okay, and the young animals like claves and the piglets, so these like nothing else but so the baby cows and so the baby pigs. Okay, so these are mostly infected, and the transmission of infection mostly we can see in the winter and the spring, and about November and April we can see these most infectious transmission. Okay, and especially the children are getting, and due to the low immunity levels only the person is going to have this type of rotavirus infection. And what is the transmission of the rotavirus? Okay, so the most of the transmission is a fecal oral route. Okay, the fecus, from the feces, and it is going to be transmitted, and it is highly communicable diseases. And whenever you are close contact with the person to person or the person to environment, and this vector transmission is more. Okay, so means nothing else but by touching itself and by airborne. So these, it is a most type of communicable diseases. And the transmission of incubation period, it will takes about 1 to 3 days, and about 10 days the observation we can see in the stool shedding. And so the amount of virus will be shedding in the stool, that is 10 to 100 billion grams of stool. These billion virus is going to be released, so that much infective, and it is so that it is also causing the diarrhea. Okay, so I'll say the reason and how it is happening. Okay, and first we'll see the structure of the rotavirus. Okay, so this is the structure of the rotavirus. Okay, and it was first recognized in the year of 1973. It was recognized, and it is belongs to the family of a Rioviridae. Okay, and it's mostly, it looks like a wheel. Okay, so the structure itself looks like a wheel. So the character, its name indicated that the wheel shaped or wheel appearance under the microscope, and it was also having the double layered capsule structure. Okay, so that is a structure regarding of the rotavirus. Okay, and so these rotavirus, and it is RNA segment only, and the serotypes is going to be present. Okay, so the different kind of serotypes, you can see that serotype group A, group B, group C, and group P, group G. So these are the response of immune response against the vaccine rotavirus. Okay, so you may think that what are the serotype, right? So this serotype is nothing else but it is a species of bacteria or the virus among immune cells, and how much it is going to be fight against. Okay, so that are the serotypes, you can see already explained, G1, G2, G3, G4 and G9. Okay, and some of the characteristics we can see like A, B, C, D. Okay, so that characteristics also we can easily recognize, A, B, C and G type and the P type serotype. So that only indicated as a 1, 2, 3, 4 and the 9 serotype consistency. Okay, and how the virus is going to be multiplies in the body structure. Okay, so instead of going to matter, and in detail in the diagram itself I'll be explaining you. So what will happen means, and whenever the virus attached to your attachment, okay, so attachment to your epithelial cells, and that is going to be enter into your body structure, cell structure of the endosomes. Okay, so that endosome, so whatever the structure is there, that is going to be forms as a lysosomes, means it will break down and it will be releasing the virus. Okay, that virus, and is going to act like a mRNA. So mRNA means the messenger means having a movement. This messenger RNA, and this virus is also consisting of a protein synthesis. Okay, so protein synthesis means, and it is going to be releases and some of the protein bonds. Okay, so that is going to be forms like a genome and RNA, and that is going to be assembled like a virus. Okay, that is called as what? Virio plasma. Videoplasma means a virus containing a nucleus, that is called as videoplasma. So it is going to be act as an enterocyte. Enterocyte means entering into the body, and it is going to be releases 100 millions of the structures in the body structure. So that is the steps of a viral replication and how it is going to be develops. Okay, and first the virus will be attaching and form an endosome in the cell, and it's going to be breakdown, and it's going to be releases a messenger RNA and the protein synthesis energy bond. It is going to be releases, and that is going to be form the structure of the RNA. And now it is a bacteria formation of the RNA. It is going to release a video plasm in nucleus and acts like an endocyte, and it's going to release 1,000 assemblages of the virus into the body structure. So that is regarding of the steps of viral replication. Okay, so already I explained that, and this virus is causing the rotavirus is causing the diarrhea. So why? So what is happening here means, and whenever the infected virus, so it will be attaching the epithelial cells. Yes. So what is happening here? So in the viral replication itself, I explained you. So whenever the virus enter and attach it to the epithelial cell, so it is going to be cause the cell destruction, means the cell damage, endoplasmic and lysosomes, lysis formation, it is going to be decreased. So what will happen here means, and it is going to be decreased absorption of the salt, water, and whatever the disaccharide molecule. So disaccharide molecule means what here? The carbohydrate substances, that is going to be, so make a liquid form in the gut lumen, so in the intestinal, in the gut lumen, and it is going to be uploaded. So what will happen? So the person will be having increased fluid secretion, and whenever the gut lumen is going to osmotic, means so low to high fluid absorptions. So what will happen here means, and the dehydration and acidosis formation is going to be there. So that only the person is going to be have the so viral infection and the diarrhea. And they are also leading to some of the immunodeficiency that is going to be cause some of the gastroenteritis, so inflammation of the gastric passages, infection it is going to be cause. Okay, and the diagnosis we can go that, so gastroenteritis, the severe diarrhea we can go, and if the person, if the children are having a gastroenteritis, and hospitalization is very very important. And findings of stool, okay, that is a enzyme immunoassay we have to conduct the test. Okay, and like laboratory diagnosis, like electron microscope is going to be used, and to detect out the virus in the stool. Okay, and ELISA test, and also rapid antigen detection test they are going to do under the stool sample only. So under stool sample only, so they can easily, so because 10 to 100 millions of virus is going to be released in the structure of virus. Okay, and treatment means, now the diarrhea is only the cause. Okay, whatever the diarrhea treatment is there, like electrolysis loss, and they are going to give the fluid and oral rehydration therapy they are going to do, and some antibiotics also they are going to give against these type of process. And in the gastric enteritis, some of the antiemetics they will give, and anti-motility drugs they will give. Okay, so that is a treatment they can give for this rotavirus. Okay, so how they are going to do the infection control? So home and daycare facilities, like for example hand washing the areas, and food preparation areas, so should be make a hand washing, and diapers changing surface, and the diaper disposable containers, and everything we have to make the process. Okay, and the toys is also going to be make the use of children's avoid by touching frequently. And some of the hospital areas, okay, like hand washing and a medical preparation area, equipment and patient care area whenever you are touching. So hand washing is very very important. Okay, so oral route.